than James chapter 4. And I had this in my heart, but it was on the floor. It just came to me, this passage of scripture. It says, "Where do wars and fights come from among you? Do they not come from your desire for pleasure, but war in your members? You lust and you do not have, murder and covet, and cannot obtain. You fight and war, yet you do not have what you want because you don't ask God for it. And even when you ask, you don't get it because your motives are all wrong. You want only what will give you pleasure. You adulterers, don't you realize that friendship with the world makes you an enemy of God? I say it again, if you want to be a friend of the world, you make yourself an enemy of God. What do you think the scripture means when they say that the Spirit of God is placed within us? The Spirit of God has placed within us is filled with envy. But He gives us even more grace to stand against such evil desires. As the scripture says, God opposes the proud, but favors the humble." That's the focal point I want you to really look at right there. But He favors the humble. He opposes those who are powerful. He opposes those who think they've, even people, religious folk, religiosity is very proud.
Yes.
He opposes the proud. He opposed Satan, Lucifer, and cast him out of heaven because he thought he could lift his throne above God's. He became powerful. The cure for being proud is to humble your heart before God and allow it to become broken before Him. And in this place, as we were worshiping the Lord, I felt even some that it began to allow their hearts to be broken even more before God.
Yeah. Yes.
Allow your heart to be broken before Him and not be hard against Him.
Yeah. Amen. Yeah.
Not to be hard against His Word or hard against the things of the Spirit, the flow of the Spirit, the river of God.
That's right.
And it can be scary, especially if you're not used to it, if you're not used to the flow of the river. It gets wild. Man, this ain't, you ain't seen nothing yet. This is a mild service.
Yeah, come on.
And I'm not even talking about people swinging from the chandeliers or dancing wildly before the Lord. Those are the outward forms of actions of what God's doing in the heart of man.
Yeah.
They've truly humbled themselves or on the floor shaking. But what I'm talking about is the depth of His glory that comes. Yes. When the depth of His glory comes, your heart will be tested.
Yeah, come on.
Humble your heart before Him.
Yeah.
Your heart will be tested. This is about the heart.
Yes, that's right.
These are weighty matters that we are involved with as children of God.
Yeah.
We're not to take the things of God as some mere natural thing.
Yes.
But we're to have our hearts humble before Him. Respect the presence of God and honor God Almighty.
Yes.
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 Not just in outward form again, but from the heart.
That's right.
Allow it to be broken before Him so that you may be able to receive from the reign of His presence, that you may be able to receive from the Holy Spirit.
Yes, that's good. That's right.
The life of God.
Yeah, come on.
We should never enter this church or any church with a nonchalant attitude.
Oh, come on now. Yes.
We should never come before the presence of the Lord with a nonchalant attitude in our bedroom.
Yep, come on.
Whenever we come to pray, it don't matter.
Yeah, that's right.
Come on.
Amen.
But we're to honor Him.
That's good. That's right.
Magnify.
Amen.
We want a heart that pleases Him.
Yeah. Yeah.
We want to be like Cornelius, whose his alms and his prayers came up before the Lord as a memorial.
Yeah.
It's because his heart was right before God.
Yeah.
He just hadn't received the revelation of salvation and being baptized in the Holy Spirit. That's why God moved upon Peter, who was on the rooftop, and gave him a vision and showed him all the different beasts, the unclean beasts. And he says, arise and eat. He said, what is he talking about? He ordered not to eat any unclean thing. He says, don't call what I have called clean unclean.
Yeah.
He's speaking of the Gentiles.
That's right.
He's called us clean. Why? Because we receive the same message.
Yeah.
And we receive of this salvation, we receive of purity, and he got to receive, Cornelius and the whole household got to hear the message of what took place.
Yeah, that's right.
And when the Holy Ghost came and blew through the place, and and the same thing happened. Peter says, well, I yet spake. Why was that speak?
That's right.
The Holy Ghost flooded and filled them just as he did us. And then he says, now listen, they were filled with the baptism of the Holy Ghost first.
Yeah.
He says, what forbids us to baptize them in water?
Hallelujah.
They believed in their heart, and the Holy Ghost just came and flooded and filled. What caused God to use Cornelius? Because his heart was right before him.
Amen.
His heart was humble.
Yeah, that's right.
And he was a part of the Italian band. He was a ruler.
Yeah, come on.
He was a leader.
Yeah.
And yet he still had a humble heart.
Amen.
Most leaders that you see, especially in the realm of the world, are very proudful men. And he was able to resist that problem. It's just because of the sincerity of his heart for God. He saw something. He saw something in Judaism at the time, because that's all he got to see. He didn't. He probably hadn't even heard about Jesus yet. Maybe he heard about it, but he didn't know the power of the gospel yet. And yet he always kept bringing alms, giving, and prayers before God. And it blessed the heart of God.
Yeah.
Says this one. It's through this one. I want to bless this Gentile.
Yeah.
It's through him. And then all the other Gentiles are going to be blessed too.
Yeah.
I'm going to do it.
Yeah, that's right.
And they began to speak in tongues. Just as they were filled with the Holy Ghost. Not just with speaking in tongues. Their speaking in tongues was the evidence that they got touched by the power of God.
Yeah, that's right.
So it's a humble heart. He resists the power that gives grace to the humble.
Hallelujah.
We've been speaking on protecting and guarding our hearts, for out of our heart flow the issues of life.
Yes.
You've received a born-again heart. You've received a new heart, a heart of flesh. Out of Ezekiel 36. 26.
Uh-huh.
Right?
Oh, yeah.
I think of that. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Ezekiel what?
36, 26. Thank you, Jesus. Getting better. Hallelujah. Receive the heart of flesh. Well, let's just go ahead and turn there. And as you're turning there, I'm also going to keep reading here. It says, therefore, submit to God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Draw near to God, and he'll draw near to you. Cleanse your hands, you sinners, and purify your hearts, you double-minded. Lament and mourn and weep. Let your laughter be turned to mourning, and your joy to gloom. Humble yourselves in the sight of God, of the Lord. He will lift you up. Humble yourselves in the sight of the Lord, and He will lift you up. Thank you, Jesus. Ezekiel 36. Relationship comes down to our heart with God and our relationship with God. That our relationship with Him must be sincere. It's not something, it's not a religious osity. It's not out of this going through the motions. And, well, I go to church on Sunday, so I'm a child of God. No. You can't say you know the Lord unless there's fruits of righteousness.
Come on.
It says in 1 John chapter 3, I believe verse 6. If there's no fruit of righteousness, you say, hey, I know God. No, you're going to have the fruit of righteousness. You're going to have the life of God that wherever you go and showing forth God's life. You say you know the Lord, don't lie against the truth, then.
Amen.
Be sure to show forth the righteousness of God.
That's right. Yeah. Come on.
Amen.
Put yourself in check every day.
Yeah.
Put your heart, humble your heart before God every day, that it remains broken before Him.
Amen.
And soft before Him.
Yeah.
And of course, the first thing that we need to do is confess Him as our Lord and personal Savior. And I believe everyone in this place has done that. And when you did do that, verse 26, and actually we'll just start in verse 25, then I will sprinkle clean water on you, and you shall be clean. And I will cleanse you from all your filthiness and from all your idols. Listen, this is what the Lord Jesus has done for us when He shed His blood upon Calvary's cross. While we're still yet sinners, Christ died for us.
Yes.
So He cleansed us with His precious blood. And He began to call out to those who were bound by the Holy Spirit to convict them, to receive the message of the cross. And of course, we need a preacher that needed to go forth. And the disciples were commissioned by God to share forth this good news. Now He commissioned 500 of them. There was only 120 that were in the upper room left over. Because they actually took His words to heart and obeyed His words. Is that a same kind of percentage that we see happen in the church?
Come on. Come on.
It's close to 80-20. But not so in this church. I'm believing that every day it's going to be more like, it's going to be 80-20 that obey, and the 80% obeying, and the 20 that we're bringing, catching them up. Amen. To obedience to the word and to the message of Calvary's cross. To have humble hearts before God.
Yes.
Listen, a proud heart cannot glory in the presence of God. It's only a humble heart.
Yeah.
But this heart of ours, we was once hard as rock and hard as stone.
Wow. Come on.
Now I received Jesus as a young child. My mom taught me the word. My dad taught me the word. We pray. I had they had word playing 24/7 on a. It started reel at first, and then it became a tape reel. They took tape cassettes, and they would wear tape cassettes and decks out of the Bible.
Wow.
Zephyr Endless Jr. The scriptures. Yeah, we just scriptures playing all the time. I thought I was going to wind up with an accent. But I didn't. It would have been kind of cool. Anyway. But the word of God was shown in my heart.
Yeah.
Listening to Kenneth Copeland and other ministers of the word of God that was preached on faith and grabbing a hold of faith, because without faith it's impossible to please the Lord.
Yeah.
Just a little side note, I remember listening to one of the tapes and he was talking about healing and crying about, and I believe it was a message about blind Bartimaeus crying out for healing, and I had chicken pox. And I was sitting there on a recliner, and I began to shout, God, I thank you that I'm healed. I cry out to you, Jesus. I'm probably third grade. Jesus, you're my healer.
Amen.
And I just kept crying it until my brothers and sisters got tired of hearing me shout it. So my mom put me in their room, and I was laying on their bed, Jesus! I think part of it was encouragement, because they wanted to go to a meeting down in Texas for this too. There was an encouragement for it. Because they're believing God with me for the healing too. But I'll tell you that those chicken pox, they scabbed up so fast. And I was back to school in no time. And they were able to go to their meeting. But is it anything because of me? No, it was because of my heart. I was hungry for God.
Yeah.
I just wanted God. And my parents taught me that, and my heart received the word. And therefore, you know, it's just that heart, soft heart, to just be for the Lord.
Yeah.
We're to keep our hearts soft. You once had a stony heart. Some of you have a different story. I have been raised in a Christian. Some of you may have been raised in a Christian home, backslid, and just ran hard with the world. Some of you were just raised in the world, and that's all you knew, and you knew nothing else. But yeah, we all once had a stony heart.
Yeah, that's right.
And we all have a different story, but the only story that matters is Jesus' story.
Amen. Come on.
The only story that matters is what Jesus did.
Yes.
And how he gave you now a heart of flesh.
Come on.
Yes.
Come on.
And cleansed you of all unrighteousness. Because you know what? Regardless of whether I was born in a Christian home or not, I was still born in a sin.
Come on.
Yeah.
Come on.
And I still needed to receive the revelation of what I was forgiven. See, he who has been forgiven much loves much.
Yeah.
That doesn't mean that even our children that are back in the back doesn't mean they have to go out and sin hard to find out and then get forgiven later in order to understand what they've been forgiven. No. They can receive the revelation from God's word, and he can teach them what they've been forgiven and what God has done. And God will give them divine revelation of this, and they will live a holy life and a righteous life. They don't have to live a backslidden life as a teenager. It is a life in the pit of hell to say your kids, when they hit teenagerhood, have to go and live for the devil. That is such a pit of hell. That is not something. Your kids will live for God. And will live in righteousness, and they're not going to create run amok, but they're going to run with the glory of God. Convicting their friends with the gospel of the truth. Amen. Such a life in the pit of hell.
Absolutely.
My children will serve God with their whole hearts.
Amen.
And not because I'm lording it over them and, you know, with this religiosity, no. But training them with the love of God. The Bible says not to provoke your children to wrath.
Yeah. That's right.
Fathers and mothers, we're not to provoke our children to this. To those things, because then they'll wind up hating you and hating God. That's why it's out of love that we need to teach and train our children. Yes, we correct them, but when you love them big time, they'll know it and they will feel it. I'm blessed to see my son. He's 14 years old, and he's, I mean, last Sunday night,
yeah, come on.
Power of God hit him. And I knew, I just went over and laid hands on him. I began to pray over, prophesy over my walking away. I knew he had something still. And then he finally gave me this look, and he came up, and he began to say, I, the Spirit of God just, you know, gave me, I forgot how he said, but some of these joints and knees left me, and he needed healing, and he began to pray for people, and God was touching people and healing people, and with the power of God, and just watching him flow with the anointing.
Yeah.
What a blessing.
Yeah.
What a blessing. Yeah. And our kids are going out on the streets, and they're preaching Jesus with boldness, and they love doing it. It's not like they feel like they're not we're not making them actually do this. They all want to go with T.O. Rick and run around with Uncle Rick and preach the gospel. They're doing it on their own. They'll look up, it says no soliciting, and let them go up and knock on the door anyway. They don't care. Say, hey, God loves you. Don't you, can't you read? No soliciting. That includes religion. He goes, oh, that's fine. I didn't come with you with religion. I'm coming with you with a relationship.
Come on, that's
boldness.
That's awesome.
Boldness.
Yes.
The boldness of God.
Yeah.
It's on the inside of him.
Yes.
People throw up all these things as like roadblocks to try to block people from, you know, they don't want to hear the gospel message. That's really what it comes down to. We can't be afraid of that. That's what will stop them in the shopping malls.
Yeah.
But listen, you know, what does this have to do with a right heart? It has everything to do with because of your willingness to be obedient to what God has called you to do.
That's right.
I'm getting to the stony heart, heart of flesh. Amen.
Yeah.
We all once had this hard heart, and the only story that matters, like I said earlier, is Jesus' story, what he has done for us on Calvary's cross.
Amen.
And you receive by divine revelation of what you've been forgiven. And when you begin, and you listen, it's a continual thing that you begin to have.
Amen.
All right? Yeah. The greater the revelation of God, the greater the revelation you're going to have of what you've been forgiven.
Yeah.
And you go, oh, God, and your heart will become even more soft before him, broken before him, so that you can grow up in him.
Amen.
Come on. He says, if you humble your heart, he says, then I will lift you up.
Yes.
Humble yourself, then I will lift you up.
Amen.
See, because a humble heart can be trusted. It's a heart of humility that can be trusted with the true riches of the anointing and the power of God.
Amen.
It's the humble heart that God can pour into and trust that will lift them up to places and elevation because he knows that they're not going to take the glory. That's why he can use unlearned men. That's why he can use the fishermen.
Yeah.
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 Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
That's why he can use the person pulled out of the streets.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
That's why he can use people like Todd White, who is just in and out, messed up all the time with drugs. His last call, man, he almost got shot. The guy just pop, 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 I'm coast blank. God spared him. You finally just said, that's it. Completely just said, no more. Went after it with his whole heart.
Amen.
Went to Teen Challenge, I think it was Teen Challenge thing or whatever they have for the drug addicts and stuff to help him. Was there like a month and then he had a vision from God and a revelation really from the Word of God.
Yeah, that's it.
Just one thing. And he had a hard time. His mind was so messed up, he couldn't even understand the Word of God at all. He couldn't understand it. It's like, I could read. He said, I could read. Barely read. But my mind, I could not put anything together. I could not understand it at all. And I had to read it over. He says, it took months of constantly just reading before he could just get something. When he got it, he realized he had it.
Yeah. Amen.
And then he left from there, and God has moved in him mightily.
Yeah.
In a mighty way.
Yeah.
What I'm just testify about him because of what he came out of.
Yeah.
He threatened his girlfriend that he would kill her if she left him. And the child and himself.
Yeah.
He says, I was convicted when I said it, just that little bit, but I still just anyway. God can take an individual's heart so messed up and it was a stone cold.
Yes.
God can do it.
Yes.
Yeah. Each and every single one of us.
Yes.
Come on.
Yes.
We've all been given the heart, the flesh.
Yes.
We've all been cleansed.
Amen.
So now I will give you a new heart and put a new spirit within you. And I will take the heart of stone out of your flesh. And give you a heart of flesh. And I will put my spirit within you and cause you to walk in my statutes.
Yes, yes.
And you will keep my judgments and do them. And you will keep his judgments and do them. You will keep his word. You will keep his statutes. Jesus says, if you love me, then you will obey my commandments.
Right.
You have been given a new heart to obey the commandments of God.
Yes.
You've been given a new heart
yes.
to surrender
yes.
to the Spirit of the living God. And plus he gave us a new spirit.
There it is.
A born-again spirit.
Yes.
It's called the new man.
Yes.
The new man.
Yeah.
You're to put on the new man, the Bible
yes.
says.
Yeah.
Colossians chapter 3, verse 10 down through. It's been given a new man. What the Spirit of God is doing today, he wants you to understand what you are guarding.
Yes.
He wants you to have a greater revelation of what you are guarding.
Yes.
For you're to guard your heart, the new man, the born-again heart, the heart of flesh.
Yeah.
For out of it flows the issues of life.
Yes.
What kind of life? The God kind of life.
Yes.
That same life that Jesus was talking about.
Yeah.
When he's talking about you must eat my flesh and drink my blood. And then he began at the very end, he says, my words, they are spirit and they are life. But what's so awesome is that his words have been written upon our hearts and put within our minds.
Yeah.
They've been written upon our minds and put within our hearts. These are words of life.
Yeah.
We have the spirit and life on the inside of us
yes.
because of our faith
yes.
in his word yes. and what he has done.
That's right.
We do not deserve it. It's called unmerited favor, his
yes.
grace.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
That's right.
The only reason why we deserve it is because he says we deserve it.
Yes.
Yes.
Not because of anything that we have done, shed,
yes.
it doesn't matter how well you dance,
come on.
Sing,
come on.
Or even preach.
That's right.
Come on.
How nice you are.
Yeah.
Come on.
There was none righteous, no, not one.
That's right.
Yes.
To be made righteous. It says, but man's mere righteousness is but the filthy rags.
That's right.
That's why we needed the righteousness of God.
Yeah.
To be made right standing with him. Our own righteousness is only but full of pride.
Yeah.
That's why you see a form of religion, but it's so full of pride and it stinks before the nostrils of God. It stinks before the nostrils of God, and this is what it looks like. It's religion. And I've read this last Sunday. With the tongue we praise our Lord and Father, and with it we curse human beings who have been made in God's likeness. Out of the same mouth comes praise and cursings. My brethren and sisters, this should not be. Can both fresh water and salt water flow forth from the same spring? What is the spring? The spring in our hearts. Up out of your belly shall flow forth rivers of living water.
Yes.
My brothers and sisters, can a fig tree bear olives or a grapevine bear figs? Neither can a salt spring produce fresh water.
That's right. Come on.
You were born again by the precious blood of Jesus. And it is not something that we are to treat as some mere thing.
Right.
Some vain thing. His blood is holy.
Yes.
And it is righteous. Right. And it's His blood that has set us apart.
Yes. Right.
He has not set us apart so that with our lips we can curse men.
Amen.
Come on.
Yes.
Come on.
Yeah.
And praise our Lord.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Come on.
That's good. Amen.
To curse our brothers and sisters in Christ.
Amen.
And encourage them. And speak the word in love and in truth.
Yes.
Yes, there's warnings that we put out there. Those things that we can put out before men. But we don't speak evil of them. And it's out of, again, our, if we bring correction, is out of a broken and contrite heart. It's out of a heart that trembles.
Yeah. Okay.
I believe it was John said that when you bring somebody back again, you got to be careful that you don't stumble into the same thing that they were.
Right.
Yes. Yeah.
In. Do it in a way that's not judging.
Come on.
Because we've all been not righteous. But now we're made righteous through the precious blood of Jesus. Amen.
Right. Amen.
So that when we help somebody out of sin, or when we minister the gospel, we understand that we're all there.
Come on. Yes.
So that when we minister with the real heart of God, the real love of God towards others. When it's like this, this is religion right here. Out of the same mouth can praise and cursings, my brothers and sisters, this should not be. Can both fresh water and salt water flow forth from the same spring? My brothers and sisters, can a fig tree bear olives or a grapevine bear figs? Neither can a salt spring produce fresh water. Who is wise and understanding among you? Let them show it by their good life, by deeds done in the humility that comes from wisdom.
Yes, yes.
But if you harbor bitter envy and selfish ambition in your hearts, do not boast about it or deny the truth.
Come on.
So do not boast about it or deny the truth.
Come on.
That you're dealing with bitterness in your heart.
Yeah, come on.
Yeah.
Or the truth of his
right.
word.
That's yeah. right. Come on.
And allow his word to work in your heart and bring forth the change.
Amen.
Amen. Yes. That's right.
We have many sitting in church pews across the nation full of bitterness, full of unforgiveness, full of anger, resentment, hurt, and pain. We have many that are sitting in pews, many standing at pulpits.
Come on.
Praising God. Yet cursing me. This is not what God has called the church to be. And the world has had a misrepresentation of who God really is.
That's right.
And as far as this church is concerned,
Come on.
It will not be so.
That's right.
Come on.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Because we are hooked up to the true church of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes, that's right.
Amen. Amen.
And we will yield to the love and the heart of God.
Amen.
Yes,
that's right.
We will hate sin.
Yes,
all our hearts.
Come on.
But we will love
yes.
people.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Come on.
Amen.
Come on.
Yes.
Come on.
Amen.
And we will love righteousness.
Yes.
Yes.
But we will not be found being a bunch of hypocrites.
Amen.
God has not called us to be hypocrites.
Amen.
In order to be free from hypocrisy, hearts must be broken. It must be right before God.
Yes.
It must be right before God. There's no room for proud being proud. I don't care how well versed you are in the Word of God.
Amen.
I don't care how hooked up to the Holy Ghost you are.
Yes.
There is no room for being proud. Because God will resist you like that.
Yes.
But He gives grace
yes.
to the humble.
Yes.
He gives ability to the humble.
Yes.
Think about that for a while. He gives grace to the humble.
Yeah.
So if things are hard, finding out living a Christian life is hard. Maybe there's some humility that needs to take place and repentance of being prideful.
Yeah, come on.
Yeah. Because He gives grace to the humble.
Yeah.
Yes.
He resists the proud, but gives grace to the humble. Now think about this. Grace is His ability to live the life He set before you.
Yeah.
Yeah, come on.
This is awesome. Jesus. I'm blessed. Are you blessed?
Yeah.
I'm loving what the Holy Ghost is bringing to us.
Yeah.
So it's a humble heart. If you are humble, then you're going to have the ability to live out what God has put before you.
That's right. Amen.
So if this walking this out and living this life is hard, then that means that we need to repent.
Yeah.
Yes.
Come on.
And humble ourselves and allow God to go deep down inside of our hearts.
Come on.
Amen.
Yeah. You know, I've had to be brought there. We've
yes,
all
sir.
Had
yes.
to
yes. come on.
Man.
Yes. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Yeah.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We want to grow and mature in God.
Yeah. Amen.
Because we want to be used by God.
Yes.
Because there's a lost and dying world that needs to be set free and delivered. And there are so many people, even in Christendom,
yes.
that need to be free.
Yes.
And they have not been taught the truth.
Right.
Come on.
They've been sitting under pastors and leaders and who haven't been giving the truth.
Yeah, come on.
And partly because even the pastors and leaders haven't received the truth.
Right?
They've been brought up in seminaries.
Yeah.
And they've been taught, and their head has been taught the word of God, but they never really got it deep within their hearts.
Amen.
They may have got the revelation of just salvation, but as far as it went, but there hadn't been so much, there's so much more to it. There's so much deep, more depth to God than this.
Yes.
Than this.
Come on.
Our wisdom is not from earthly wisdom. And
right.
sensual, but it is, but and demonic, but it is from heaven. It's
yes.
from God.
Yes.
And the wisdom that we receive is spirit knowledge.
Amen.
It's revelation knowledge of who God is.
Yes.
It's revelation knowledge. When you read the Word of God and submit your heart to the Word of God, receive it as spirit knowledge, revelation knowledge.
Yes.
Quit trying to get your head full with it.
Come on.
Because then you'll miss God every single time.
That's right.
And you'll misinterpret His Word.
Yeah, come on.
The truth of His Word won't come across as it's supposed to.
Yeah.
Amen.
Comes from divine revelation. That's why when you get in the Word, just read it, not to put the message together.
Amen.
I read the Word. There'll be times, Sunday mornings, even, I'll get in the Word, and I will not read it so that I can put a message together
come
for
on.
You. Last Saturday, I got in the Word. spent time in the Word of God. First for myself. Then began to just ask the Lord and then let Him pull it up again. What He wanted me in ministry. Because I don't want to do, and this message is just from my heart. This is not, I didn't have this, He just gave me the scriptures.
Amen.
It's by the Holy Ghost. And how could I have I brought this out if I had not been in the Word? Study.
Come on. That's good.
Amen.
Well, let's continue. Here says, I'll just read verse 13 again. Who is wise and understanding among you? Let them show it by their good life, by deeds done in the humility that comes from wisdom.
Right.
But if you harbor bitter envy and selfish ambition in your hearts, do not boast about it or deny the truth. Such wisdom does not come down from heaven, but is earthly, unspiritual, and demonic.
Come on.
For where you have envy and selfish ambition, there you will find disorder in every evil practice. You will find disorder in every evil practice.
What verse is that?
17, chapter 3. James, chapter 3, verse 17. It was at 16? Oh, yeah. But the wisdom that comes from heaven is first of all pure, then peace-loving, consecrated, submissive, full of mercy and good fruit, impartial and sincere, peacemakers who sow in peace, reap a harvest, righteousness.
Amen.
Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Jesus. I still haven't gotten to the... Did I get to the flesh and stone? Did I read that?
Yeah,
you can
see
it. It's good.
But out of the soft heart, go ahead and turn with me to Proverbs chapter 4. Because we're going to read 20 through 27. I know I've been quoting, and our main verse that we've been speaking upon is Proverbs chapter 4 and verse 23. My son, give attention to my words. Incline your ear to my sayings. Do not let them depart from your eyes. Keep them in the midst of your heart.
Amen.
The Father, in His Word, He says, that is not my word like a hammer that breaks up the rock? See, the Word of God tills the ground of our hearts.
Yeah, that's right.
It also is as the water that causes our hearts to be refreshed and cause that soil to be watered. It's also the seed that's planted. So that the Word can become alive and real on the inside. See, it's the broken and contrite heart. Constantly commit your heart to the Word of God so that you can keep your heart soft and pliable to God.
Yeah.
And that's why we're to incline our ear to hear the Word of God that comes into our hearts. and that we keep them in the midst of our hearts. So it's not just listening to the word of God. But it's pondering the message that comes across. It's to meditate on the word.
Yeah.
It's the meditation of the word that's going to continue to till.
That's right.
You notice that we've been on this ministering on guard your heart for the last, I think we're hitting the third week now. For out of it flows the issues of life.
Yes.
Part of the reason why I've been hitting this and I feel the Spirit of God has been leading us is because even before that, we've been ministering on the tactics of the enemy.
Yeah.
And because God's doing such awesome things in this group, in this church, we have to protect the unity of the Spirit.
Yeah.
We have to protect the love of God.
Yeah.
We have to protect this and allow no room, no foothold of the enemy to get into you, create anger, hurt, strife, bitterness, whatever, unforgiveness, whatever. If somebody offends you, forgive them.
Amen.
Yeah.
Yes.
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 Come on.
That's the scripture.
Yes. 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 Yeah.
Forgive them.
Yes.
That's right.
Thank you, Lord.
Especially if they're your brother.
Come on.
Your sister. The Bible says if you have aught against anyone, then come to them. Deal
yes.
with the situation.
Yes.
But deal with it in a spirit of love.
Yes.
Deal with it from the word of God instead of your own opinion and your own.
Yeah.
Because all that's going to do is all they're going to do is they're going to go.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. Yes. Yes.
And then you got to fight on your hand,
yes.
and then there's going to be more bitterness and
yes.
more anger, and there's going to be resentment, and then you have an issue.
Yeah.
And it's only going to take the grace of the mercy should have gone out to deal with this thing. Because we know out of Philippians, Paul had to deal with, he talked about the two women out of chapter 4 that needed to work together.
Yes.
He says, encourage these two women to work together.
Come on.
So obviously, he's had to deal with stuff. I encourage all of you to work together by the Spirit and by the Word of God.
That's right.
That's right.
And the best way to do this is to keep your heart humble.
Yeah.
If you can humble your
heart.
Right.
That's
see, a humble heart will look at a situation and will step back and collectively look at the situation, look at their own actions and see if their actions were wrong.
Yeah.
See if their actions were if they were missing the inside place. That's where the Lord, we said, submit one to another out of the fear of the Lord.
Yeah, that's right. Come on.
We prayed this morning. I prayed that out. It was just submitting one to another in the fear of the Lord. If we're all in the fear of God, have fear of the Lord, then we can submit one to another.
That's right.
Because then nobody is going to be trying to lift themselves above anybody else.
Yeah.
In this powerful sense. There's no room for a heart of pride.
Yeah.
Now, I'm not talking about there being an order in church with pastors and leaders and all that, and leadership and listening to the authority of the leadership and all that, and as long as that authority is committed to God and to keeping a humble heart, it's all going to be in right order.
That's right.
And everyone's going to have that safety that they need to have.
Right.
Amen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And part of what we're dealing with in this society is a resistance against authority because authority has abused their authority.
Yeah.
Men have abused their authority, so now you have all kinds of problems and situations. But how is this situation going to be fixed? By everyone's submitting one to another out of fear of God.
Amen.
Amen.
That's right.
Amen.
It's divine.
Yes.
It's the only way that it's
going
to happen. Is that we yield. Thank you for that word. Divine.
Yeah.
It's by the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's by our hearts being completely broken before the Lord.
Yeah.
Yeah.
that's why, you say if some, you know, somebody, what did he say, Jesus? Oh, yeah. He said, if somebody slaps you on the cheek, turn the other one else.
Yeah.
That's humility.
Yeah.
It's a strong man, it's gospel.
Amen.
Yeah. It requires you to be strong.
Right.
To live that kind of life. Will you be able to turn the other one also? It reminds me of the Roman, not the Roman, the early church. And I was reading through Jesus Freak's book, The Martyrs.
Yeah.
Fox Books and Martyrs.
Yep.
Yeah.
And they had got a hold of one of these Bible teachers and were just beating him and doing all kinds of stuff. And telling him we're going to kill these people and all, everything. But they begin to torture him and slice open his cheeks. There was so many more horrible things he did to the man. And all he said is, "Thank you for giving me more mouths in which I can praise my God or go proclaim the gospel." That's a broken and contrite heart. Stephen, as he's being stoned, "Father, forgive them, for they don't know what they do." That's from a heart that is broken and contrite. It's not full of pride, and it's not fighting for its own defense. It's just letting God be the defender.
Amen.
As we talked about how Stephen, really, what he did was the sacrifice of your, now obviously Jesus' blood was the blood that was that got a hold of Saul, who became Paul.
Right.
But still, his life was sown in a way, because what if Paul only had an encounter with God, if Stephen did not die.
Come on.
It's just the way things took place. But that's the kind of heart that we must have. Willing to even die for our very faith.
Yeah.
And not sit here and defend our own opinions or our own beliefs.
Amen.
Because our own opinions do not matter. Our own beliefs do not matter. The only beliefs is this, and really this is what needs to become our opinion.
Right.
This is what needs to become our beliefs.
Yes.
Right here.
Yes. Amen.
And if you read in the Word of God, as you're reading in the Word of God and committing your heart to the Word of God, and it's not lining up with what you see, your life, your opinions, and your beliefs aren't lining up with the opinions of the Word of God, then humble yourself.
Yes. Amen.
Very your heart.
Amen.
Humble your heart before the Lord.
Amen.
So keep them in the midst of your heart. Till. Keep that ground soft. For they are life to those who find them, and health to all their flesh. So there's a promise that comes with all of this. You go, "Man, that sure seems kind of harsh," but no, it's not, because there's a great promise that far surpasses dying to your own self. There's a promise that far surpasses, a blessing that far surpasses dying to your own wants, dying to your own opinions, dying to your own beliefs. Keep your heart with all diligence, for out of it spring the issues of life. Hallelujah. What we've been focusing on. I'm just praying that gets so lodged deep on the inside of you. That as you're sleeping, that's all you hear.
Amen.
And that love the Lord thy God with all your heart. Amen.
Yeah.
All your strength, every part of you.
Amen.
Amen. Keep your heart with all diligence, for out of it it springs the issues of life. And put away from you a deceitful mouth, and put perverse lips far from you. Now this is how you guard it.
Yeah.
You've got to put away those things. Put away the perverse lips. Put away the deceitful mouth. Because your own words are a snare. Your own words will ensnare you. Either set you free or ensnare you, one of the two. So you might as well speak the word of God.
Hallelujah.
And then I'm thankful that there is repentance for blowing it.
Yeah.
That's right.
But I'd rather have a control over my tongue.
Yes.
And how do I have control over my tongue? That I am hooked up to the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
Yield it completely, and then I commit my heart to His Word, which is even the discerner of the thoughts and the intents of the heart.
Yeah.
You keep your heart submitted to His Word. You keep meditating on His heart, His Word on a continual basis. As you're doing that, you're actually putting a guard over your mouth.
Yeah.
Because out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. So if there's not that time of meditation of the word in your heart, not just reading it, but taking it, reading, and meditating on it in your heart, muttering it over and over and over, then you're putting the guard over your mouth. And then you're being led by the very bit of His Word. He's guiding you. And no longer. Then you're trained. Then you're going to have words that are seasoned with salt.
Yes.
And that are going to bless men. Out of Colossians chapter 4. Let's read that. Put your feet, hold your finger there and I'll finish reading that. Colossians chapter 4, 5 and 6. Likewise, among those who are not believers in... Okay, here. Yeah, I did get it right? Okay. Walk in wisdom toward those who are outside, redeeming the time. Let your speech always be with grace, seasoned with salt. Now stop for a moment. Let your speech always be seasoned with grace. Grace. What do we talk about? Grace is His ability.
Yeah. Amen.
It's also His unmerited favor, but favor and ability.
Yeah.
His grace enables you. Because what does grace do? Grace teaches us to say no to ungodliness.
Yeah.
Alright? Titus chapter 2. So therefore, that grace is also teaching us to put a guard over our mouth.
Amen.
Yeah.
That's right.
To not be say something stupid. That hurts others.
Amen.
Amen. Look at this. So walk in wisdom towards those who are outside, redeeming the time. Let your speech always be with grace, seasoned with salt, that you may know how you ought to answer each other. So that you may know how you ought to answer each other.
Come on. Good.
Man. What did it earlier say in James chapter 3? Is able to tame the tongue as a perfect man, one who is able to not hurt people in the words with the words that they say, but always bless others. Man, they are perfect.
Yeah.
Listen, we're perfected in Him. The key to all of this is that we remain in Christ Jesus. The key is that we keep our hearts humble before the Lord.
Amen.
And continue to receive from the life of God, the Word of God. Verse 25 of Proverbs, chapter 4. Back again, back to where we're at. Let your eyes look straight ahead, and your eyelids look right before you. Ponder the path of your feet, and let all your ways be established. Do not turn to the right or the left. Remove your foot from evil. Pure and undefiled religion. take care of orphan and widows, and to keep yourself unspotted from the world.
Yeah.
Just keep your feet from evil.
Yeah. Come on.
Keep your feet from those things.
Yeah.
This is how we guard our heart. Yeah. But you know, as the heart goes, so does the feet.
Right.
So does goes the mouth. Should I say, out of the heart, so goes the mouth.
Yeah.
Then out of the mouth, so goes the feet.
Yeah. Come on, man.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
This was that the word of God is a light unto our path.
Yeah.
Right? Light unto our path. Feet. And a lamp unto our path.
Yeah.
Did I go backwards?
Yeah.
See this? Okay. A light, a lamp unto my feet, a light unto my path. There we go. Thank you. So it's a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. We speak the word of God. It's a lamp unto your feet. It's a light unto your path. It's coming up out of your heart. Amen.
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 Let's believe that concludes today. I don't have anything else ready right now that's rolling around that Holy Ghost is giving me. Man, I need to listen to that again because that was pretty good. Let's speak to the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. I could put that together. That was definitely God.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. That's why we just yield to the Holy Spirit.
That's right.
Amen. You don't need another. You don't just. We don't need just more orators.
Come on now.
Yeah.
That can sound good.
That's the truth.
We need people to bring forth the Word of God out of the Spirit of wisdom.
Amen.
That's what we want. Now, obviously, it can come forth sound good. Forthly. Come forth with fullness. But still, it's just hearing the truth and getting a divine revelation. Amen.
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 Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.